Hey guys, Michael Blackwell again. We're continuing on with our study of the seven churches of Asia, and we are now on our fifth church, the church at Sardis, known in history as the Reformation Church. And we're going to be looking at Revelation chapter 3, verses 1 to 6. So let's see if we can go ahead and read that together in preparation of this. If I can just get this slide to advance. There we go. Revelation chapter 3, verses 1 to 6. And to the angel of the church in Sardis write, "These things says he who has the seven spirits of God and the seven stars. I know your works, that you have a name, that you are alive, but you are dead. Be watchful and strengthen the things which remain that are ready to die, for I have not found your works perfect before God. Remember, therefore, how you have received and heard. Hold fast and repent. Therefore, if you will not watch, I will come upon you as a thief, and you will not know what hour I come upon you. For, verse 4, you have a few names, even in Sardis, which have not defiled their garments, and they shall walk with me in white, for they are worthy. He who overcomes shall be clothed in white garments, and I will not blot out his name from the book of life, but I will confess his name before my Father and before his angels. Verse 6, he who has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit says to the churches." All right, so the word Sardis means a remnant, and this stage in the life of the Church of Sardis basically pictures the Reformation period. So there's been 1,000 years basically of papal domination, and the churches now start to escape from Roman Catholicism. And although they do escape from Roman Catholicism, they fall into the trap of a dead theology and a lifeless formalism. If you really want to see a graphic picture of this, you'll go to Europe. You can travel through Italy, Austria, Germany, France, England. Basically, you could spend the rest of your life just visiting the churches and cathedrals in those countries. There's so many of them. They're dotted all over the place. So it's one of the ways that the church used to control people, by having those churches within walking distance of all the communities. So there's a lot of them. And these churches, they were built beautifully. They're stunning, but there's no spiritual life in these churches. When I go to those churches, I've had the privilege of going to Europe and visiting those churches in France and in Germany. And when I visit those churches, I get the creeps, really, the heebie-jeebies. They're kind of scary. And when I walk around inside these dark buildings with all these really weird paintings and pictures of Jesus and statues of Jesus and Mary, all I can think of is what has happened here. And then you go into some of the other churches that don't have the statues of Jesus, but because they're not Catholic, they'll be Lutheran or Anglican or other types of churches. But what you find is that these churches, they're not really churches. They've become monuments. Really, a lot of them are just museums. And to be honest with you, and this isn't stretching the truth, many of them are just mausoleums. They're just places for the dead, right? I mean, that's just where a bunch of people have been buried. Nothing is going on in these churches. There is no life in them. And what is really shocking about it is if you think about the people who started those churches, the men who started those churches, they were men really and women of great faith, right? During the Reformation, the Bible was translated and it was published at great cost. People were losing their lives. They were being persecuted for doing this. They did this so that the word of God could be put into the hands of the people so they could read it for themselves, and they wouldn't have to listen to what the Pope had to say or anyone else had to say. They could see for themselves and not be misled, and they could read it for themselves in their own language. And they did this because they didn't want people to be controlled by the papacy. They did this so that people could live their lives in a way that is pleasing to God. And this is what's awesome, right? The Reformation was radical. It was powerful. It literally changed the course of nations. But it clearly died. I mean, you go into those churches, there's nothing going on there. And the question has to be, how did this happen? Well, it died because the old traditions of the Roman Catholic Church, like infant baptism, the union of church and state, clerical hierarchy, all those things are still found in the Reformation Church. Essentially, they didn't reform enough. They didn't get rid of all the heresies. And so what God does here is he calls on these churches to remember the truths that were committed to them, to hold fast to his word, to repent for the slack way of how they've treated God's word. All right, well, we need to wrap up this church, and I'd like to wrap it up with one final thought. You know, it's great to think of the church at Sardis as being historical, right? But we can't forget that this message also relates to us as well. And we need to be careful that we don't become a church that where we get together and we like to sing the songs, we like to listen to the messages, we like to say a few prayers, we like to fellowship with other believers, we like to serve here or there and throw a few bucks in the offering plate. We need to be careful that we don't do all those things but still remain spiritually dead. You know, it can happen. A lot of people go to church, but they've never accepted Jesus Christ as their personal Savior. You have to understand, being a member of a church will not save you. Being baptized as a baby in a church will not save you. It is only by placing your faith in Jesus Christ alone for your salvation. That's what will save you. And being saved, to be honest with you, nothing else matters. So ask yourself, have I placed my faith in Christ Jesus for my salvation? Or have I fallen into the trap of following the traditions of the old church? And if you have, you might not be saved. It is a personal decision where you need to place your faith in Christ Jesus alone. Well, that is that church. We're going to move on to the church at Philadelphia, which is a lot more positive. It is known as the Missionary Church.